WBIF Champions Cup 2023, 8th round, Carlo Melzi versus Ernst Kümin. Carlo Melzi plays bottom with black checkers, and the Swiss player Ernst Kümin, I think, play bottom with play top with white checkers. Double four. For one, eight checkers. Double one, very good roll. Now we are very close to a double, but Carlo manages to make the anchor. I think that maybe the double is a bit early. It is a clear take. I would hit from the mid because he, Ernst has the chance to make the six prime. He hits, but Carlo hits back. Ernst make the golden point. Yes, 3 points for Carlo. Now Ernst has to bring at home the three back checkers, so it is not a, a wonderful situation for him, especially because Carlo owns the cube. But Ernst hits another checker. Double two, I would make the 7 point. 5 prime, very important. Five treats, another checker. Yes, 18-15. Because in this way he has three builders for the six prime. But probably it's not so important to make the six prime because white has is head in the race, has a huge advantage in the race, so it's not so important to prime Carlo. I would hit on the 7 point. Not an easy game. Now Ernst has two checkers on the bar. I don't think Carlo can double, even if Ernst has three blots in the outfield, and Carlo doubles. If Carlo rolls a six, he can hit a lot of checkers. But I think I would take. Ah, no, I had not seen that it is not a 5 prime, it is a 4 prime. So I completely agree with Carlos doubles, and I think it is a drop, because Carlo hits with a 6 and a 5. So it's very... He has a lot of gammons. So the double were correct, but it was not a drop, but it was a very scaring double. So very good double by Carlo, 2-0 for Carlo. Interesting double too. Maybe he could have made the golden point, the so-called Kirin point, or as I call it, the curing point, because it is much more important when the opponent has made the 4 point. Carlo can hit on the 3 point. But he has only 8 checkers in the zone. I would make the 5 point. Now Carlo hits because he has not to clear the 8 point. And now it is a strong double, I think, because he has a lot of chance to cover the 4 point. It is a prime versus prime position, but not easy for Ernst. I don't know if he had to play 4-1, 4-3. Putting 2 checkers on the bar. I think he has to run, yes. 6-4, the perfect roll. Now full prime for Carlo. Now he needs a 5 or 6. 5 arrives. I would play yes to the 6, because it can be interesting to hit another checker. Five, three hits. It is not clear if Ernst has to eat, because it is a bit dangerous. Probably I would not eat. Now I think that Carlo Gammon chances are something like 15%. Now a bit less, because the two checkers, the two spares on the deuce point are not good. Or not bad. Double one, very good roll. For one from the four. I would play 4-3-4 off. No, this Carlos move is correct. No gammons, so Carlo leads 4-0. Carlo is playing under 2 and Ernst at 7, because he made a big blunder with the drop last game. Double 5. Very good anchor. Make the 5 point. Thirteen-ten. Nice slot by Carlo. Ernst hit from the bar. I think this is not a double yet, but we are not far from it. Ernst doubles and easy take for Carlo. 11-8. It's the 5 point, and now Carlo's position is very good. I like his position. The 3 is duplicated, double 4, cover the 5 point and make the deuce point. Carlo needs a 5 or 6 to increase his timing. To improve his timing. I would play 10-5. I think it is a bit risky. Twelve three. Double 5, wonderful roll for Carlo. Yes, I like this one. No, GNU doesn't like. For 2, I'd play 16-12 and 8-6. Six, five, wonderful roll for Ernst. But Carlo hits. And now I think it is too good for Carlo, but the 4 is duplicated. And the double 3 is not a very good roll. Four, two, I think maybe this is a bit risky. I would play 17-15 because the double 4 would have been a huge joker for Ernst. Can pass. Carlo has a huge gammon chances. He can pass. He can pass another time. Two off. I think he has more than 60% gammon chances. Double 6, wonderful. Now it leaves a blot. And Ernst hit. I think it is too good. I would not redouble. If Ernst manages to hit Carlo's straggler and close his board, he has only 24% winning chances. So I think it is too good for Carlo. X3, and now Ernst doesn't hit, and I think he has to run from the 23 to try to avoid the backgammon. Yes. No backgammon, but Carlo now leads 8-0. Carlo is playing at 2.2 and Ernst under 5. No, I don't think it is correct. Very strange that Carlo makes an error on the second roll. Now it is it can be a double. I think I would double at this score. Is 5 pips ahead in the race and he has a lot of chances to hit the checkers on the bar point. So the double is correct and the take two, of course. I think I would make the 3 point. I would play for a gammon, so I would take some risk. No, I don't like this one. It's too unflexible. This is a bit better, but I would have made the 3 point. Sorry, just a moment. Okay, sorry, but I had a phone call. Blitzing position for Ernst and with the second checker. And I think I would go to the bar point. Yes, I like this one. For two, I would pick and pass, I would make the ace point. It is a blitz, so it is not important one point or the other. And here I think I would make the double tiger. Not so sure the double tiger is the correct move, but Carlo manages to anchor. And now we can he has chances to avoid the gammon and to win the game too, because it's not easy for Ernst to bring at home his back checker. No, I don't like this one, because Ernst on board is much stronger. Yes, yes, to it, it's a bit dangerous, but Carlo has some winning chances. Double six, very good roll. And I would hit on the ace point. I would make the ace point. No, I don't like this one. Yes, and I would go down from the mid. Not an easy choice, it's a bit risky, but I think that Carlo has some winning chances after this move. But this is the correct move, because Ernst Struggler doesn't see daylight, and Carlo has the complete outfield control. I would play 16-11 and 13-12, completely controlling the outfield and creating four builders for the 8 point. Yes, I think this is the best one. Double one, I would make the ace, the eight. I think I would prefer to make the 8 point, even if this is very strong, because it creates four builders for the 4 point. This is not the best move. Okay, now he makes the 8 point just in time. I think yes, he has to advance his straggler. If Carlo was not so ahead in the score, it would be a strong redouble. Now maybe it could be a redouble. And now I think Carlo can cash. But maybe it is too good. Why not? He can play on. Two makes the deuce point. I would have hit on the ace point. Carlo's gammon chances are, I think, something like 3%, not more. Double six. And now double five. I was thinking if Ernst was favorite, but double five by Carlo is a crashing roll. And now it is a cash. Carlo missed a lot of doubles. But not big mistakes. 10-0 for Carlo. Double one. I think I would slot the bar point. Yes, I like this one. 3-1, 24-21, and make the 9 point. Yes, I think I would go down from the mid. Ernst hit. I think he could double in this position because he had a very strong hit, and the score is 10-0. Very good 6-1 for Ernst, for Carlo. 6-3, wonderful roll. But now Ernst is ahead in the race just by 5 pips, so it is not a double for sure. He can slot the 5 point, but of course he is not so happy to slot. I don't like this one. Only 2 pips behind in the race for Carlo. He has to decide if staying back for trying to hit a checker, but probably it was better to go to the bar point, to the opponent's bar point. But another hit. Okay, this is the safe move. Probably it is the best one. Too dangerous to leave the shot. Ernst has to play safe. Now Ernst is 6 pips ahead in the race. He has not a double. Would play from the 8. On the 8. Carlo is playing under 3 and Ernst under 4, so very well played match. Six one four three maybe. Now I think I would not double, but double 6, the best roll, and it was not a double, doubling was a blunder. Double 5, no gammon, so 10-2 for Carlo. Six five for Ernst. Very good double two for Carlo. That now is a good position, but is behind in the race. I would have played safe, 13-4. Now, for yes, the rack with the 3 point. So very good position for Carlo. 4 point for Ernst. For 3 hits on the deuce point. Yes, I agree. Five two is not a good roll, but Ernst keeps on dancing. Carlo takes a bit a small risk trying to make the 6 prime. Now he has good gammon chances. Double 3 closes the board. And I think that gammon chances are around 50%. Maybe more than 50%. One off. Now at least 65% gammon chances. The double 5 is a very good roll. Double 6. Now Carlo needs a double for winning the gammon. 8-2-6-7-3. And now it is not necessary a double. I got confused. Now it is Crawford, 12-2. I would cover the 7 point. I don't like this because the gammon is not so important for Ernst at this score. Yes, I prefer this one. but it seems correct. Would make the 8 point and the 7 point. Why not? Run. To one hit, it's Ernst dances. 6-3 makes the 7 point. Now makes the 4 point. Carlo is ahead in the race. It is prime versus prime position. Very good double slot for Carlo. Yes, I like this one. Double three, wonderful roll for Carlo because he makes the advanced anchor. And now he's a big favorite to win the game and the match. Five, three, two, one. Carlo needs a 4 or 5 or 6. 5-4. And now he's more than 90% favorite to win the game. No, maybe not more than 90%, but close to 90%. Six three has to run. One closes the board, and now Carlo's chances are higher than 98%. Now it is close to 100%. Carlo plays the under 3 and Ernst at 3.5, so a very well played match. Congrats to both players and especially to Carlo that goes further in the Champions Cup. Ernst is loses his third match and is out of the competition. So, congrats to both and thanks to all the viewers. See you next.